changing room with him. The whole entourage has now made their way to ringside. And Tyson Fury, he looks a happy guy, doesn't he? Been around an awful long time now and still only 24 years old. And moving towards a summer showdown, maybe against Derek Chisora, and maybe a shot at the world title. His fans are here in numbers, all getting pictures of the big moment. The two fighters are just about ready, and in a moment or two, we can get the big formal introductions from Mark Burness.
Ladies and gentlemen, Frank Warren for Queensbury Promotions, in association with Hennessy Sports, sponsored by Raynham Steel, proudly presents a 10 3-minute round international heavyweight contest. Your officials are appointed by the British Boxing Board of Control. Your stewards in charge this evening are Mr. Mick Colliatt and Phil Lundgren. Your timekeeper of the bell is Mr. Peter McCann of Ryslip. Now to introduce the contestants. Firstly, weighing in 241 pounds. That's 17 stone, 3 pounds, fighting out of the red corner, wearing the black shorts with a record of 29 wins, 7 losses, with 28 knockouts to his name. Please welcome, from Minnesota, USA, Chewy Arbell. And across the ring, fighting out of the blue corner, is a former British and Commonwealth champion, wearing the white, green and gold shorts, weighing in 275 pounds, that's 19 stone, 8 pounds, with an unbeaten record of 21 wins, with 50 knockouts to his name. Please welcome, from Palm Beach, Dan, Tyson, Too Fast, Fury! Charge of the action is Mr. Jeff Hines of Reading, who will now give his final instructions to both boxers.
A little smile between them, as much as to say, on both part maybe, you know what's coming. A little bit of a blink and don't miss it fight, this one. It could be fast and furious while it lasts. I know who my money's on, Eddie.
First round.
But it's all about Tyson just keeping his composure, isn't it? Keeping his discipline. I think that's the key for a Fury win. Good jab there from Tyson.
Fury, you can see with the height and reach advantage. Only one fight though in the last year. Had to cope with the disappointment of those cancellations of the fights against David Haye. And you wonder psychologically what sort of effect that has had. Southpaw, his opponent tonight. But just a little bit square. Fury, I know, within the British boxing game, if you speak to people, they all say his boxing abilities, actual boxing skills, are a little bit underrated, Eddie.
I think so, too. You know, I've been able to go to camp with this guy when he's in shape, and even, you know, which I've only seen him in shape, he can box with the best of them, and he's 6'9", which also adds another wrinkle to the toughness it is to get to him.
Just caught by a left hand by Abel, and he's going to be a little bit dangerous in the early stages, this 32-year-old American.
I know Joey pretty well. I mean, I've actually had some rounds sparring with him. And, yeah, the ice is real. He can throw that left hand hard, you know, with the best of them. Problem with Joey is, you know, he can stand and watch and can be a bit chinny as well. So, you know, just got to be...
That's that left hand again.
Good shot. As long as, you know, Tyson is careful and lands those shots, you know, and forces Joey to have to, you know, come to him, the fight will be in his hands.
Well, it's part of the appeal, Barry, of Tyson Fury, is that he does have that vulnerability, and he's inviting the Americans come forward now and have another go.
Well, he loves a tear-up, doesn't he? You know, he, being 6'9", with good boxing skills and long reach, he doesn't need to get involved, but he likes to. That's what makes him exciting. But he's already having a lot of success with the jab, and against a southpaw, that's a good result. I think just a little slip there from Tyson.
Good solid body shot, though, again, from the American, and Fury certainly not having things all his own way in this opening round, as we suspected. Far side of the ring there, interested observer, you'll recognise the familiar face, that's Chris Eubank. Nice right hand from Fury, right on the bell. How did he score it, Barry?
Yeah, I think that's a clear round for Tyson. I think, you know, he dominated behind the jab. I think, you know, Abel had a couple of successes, landed with one shot in particular, but apart from that, I think it was all Fury dancing on the outside, taking a look at Joey Abel.
Let's listen into the corner, Tyson Fury with Peter Fury, his trainer.
Know what you're doing, just draw him on, and do a little bit, do a few more feints, yeah? Stepping off. Don't do anything silly like leaning over to the stomach just yet, yeah? With the body shot. Very important, he's very nervous, yeah? So this time, just pick it up a little bit, close the distance on him, keep the front foot on, yeah? The front foot on him, feint, and you're just moving him around, yeah? And let's let another round go by, and we'll pick it up on him.
Okay.
Yeah?
I got that.
I got you. He's a character, isn't he?
He's a real character.
He's tough and he's game. One of the things he said, when it comes down to it, what I like's rocking. Oh. He likes to fight, the big fella.
Yeah, he's a fun guy all around, believe me, I know.
Sounds as though he's had a pretty traumatic week, though, with the illness to his wife. Yeah. And the business back home with the attack on his home, or on his property. Oh, good left hand from Abel, and Fury certainly wants to hold on and buy a second or two after that, and complaining about use of the heads, Tyson Fury.
Yeah, it was Joey Abel when he just came in with the head there after landing with a good shot.
Big warning from Jeff Hines saying, any more of that, I'm going to have you out of there.
Comes with the excitement when somebody sees an opportunity, land a good shot, and oh, I want to use my head too. We've seen that same thing with Victor Ortiz and Floyd Mayweather at one point too.
Yes. Second round here of this 10 rounder, and Tyson Fury already, as well as showing the ability, is showing the vulnerability, yeah, which makes him such a must watch sort of fighter.
Right. Yeah, absolutely. But you can see right now, he's right now sticking to the jab, you know, staying behind the jab, looking for the opening, making Joey, you know, take the initiative to come forward. Eventually, it's going to open up. That right hand is going to come down the pipe.
Tyson Fury can't afford any sort of slip up here tonight, Barry. An awful lot goes out of the window if he does so. Not only the Chisora fight, but of course, he's got that high ranking and looking towards a world title shot. Got to deliver here.
Yeah, and he's boxing okay. He's dominating behind the jab. He just makes silly little mistakes, like he leans forward with the right hand rather than turning from the hips, from the waist. He's leaning forward with the right hand, shortening the gap and giving Abel an opportunity to land his own shot. So he just keeps his discipline. That's all he needs to do, and it'll be an easy night's work for Fury.
Solid right hand, and the head's coming in close again. I think that was 6 of 1 and half a dozen of the other. I don't think that was any sort of malicious intent on Abel's part. It was purely, I think, the fact that Fury was on the front foot and coming in himself.
Yeah. Southpaws and right-handed fighters, you're going to get a lot of the head clashes and stepping on the foot and things like that. It just happens in boxing with these kind of, with these two kind of guys.
Tyson Fury said that he reckoned that the David Hay business cost him £5 million. Whether or not that's so, I suppose if you see 5 million go, that's going to test anybody's sense of good humour, isn't it? Not that I'd know.
Oh, Lord. £5 million.
Nice jabbing from Fury.
Very disciplined behind the jab.
And you can see the effect it's having on Abel, a little lump just above the right eye.
We saw him get discouraged, didn't we, against Pulev. Come out for the fifth round, and he's just starting to get to him here with that jab, Fury. But that's the dangerous left hand from Abel, and he's fancying it. Looking to tee off Chuck Fury and to unload a big shot. Fury cute to that and able to block the danger. Yeah, another round to Fury, Barry.
I think he dominated behind the jab, except for a couple of little scares there. I still think, you know, the majority of the work behind the jab was done by Tyson. But Abel's shown enough danger signs for Fury to be cautious, to be worried, and to give more discipline, I think, in the next round.
No, I don't know. Okay. That's fine. You got to use your jab a little bit more and step out. That's where he's hitting you with that jab. He's bugging you in the eye here. Keep stepping over this way. When you get him cornered, throw a straight left hand and roll back with the hook, then the left hand. Okay? Don't reach with it. Don't bring your feet, throw the straight left hand down and roll with the hook.
Hold it 10 seconds.
Nice deep breath. Big deep breath.
Entertaining stuff so far.
Six out, round three.
So into the third round. Steve Bunce predicted that Tyson Fury was going to get off the canvas to win this one. Joey Abel's going to have to find the target before too long.
I think as long as Tyson stays behind the jab, it's going to force Joey to put action forward. And I think as he's going to come forward, he's going to run right into the right hand. I know I said it before, and I don't want to belabor it, but it's going to end up happening. You can see he gets a little desperate, you know what I mean, because he's got to get past that long, educated jab.
You're just joining us. That's the voice of Eddie Chambers, who's been in the Tyson Fury camp. A little bit of talking there from Tyson Fury. I think it might have been directed to you before.
I'm not even looking at him. I don't even want to get involved in that.
I'm not a big talker, we know that.
Well, he doesn't want to be distracted in any sense, because Abel does have that power, and he's landed a couple of times with that left hand. He does so again there, Barry.
Yeah, and too easy for my liking, I think, you know. As Eddie was saying, not as Tyson just dominates behind the jab, it's an easy night's work.
Very
good right hand there from Fury. Well, what's all this about? Suggesting he's using the shoulder?
I think he's just having a little fun in there with him. But like we know Joey can be very dangerous. And, you know, the gamesmanship is all good, but I think he's only going to do it when he knows he can. You know what I mean?
Good right hand there from Fury.
He's getting a bit rough in there now.
Oh, yeah.
Jeff Hines is going to have to... Oh, hello. Well, that's after the break. That's after the call to break. Now, what's the referee going to do out of this? A few boos and jeers from the crowd. Tyson Fury suggesting to Abel, come on, get up. Now, what is Jeff Hines going to do? He's going to give him time. Tyson Fury having a chat with one or two people at ringside, leaning over the ropes.
And it was low and it was late.
Two strikes, huh?
He'll give him time.
You were missing a break there, right? You still hit. And hit him low.
That was a body shot.
Keep your shots up and listen to my commands, right?
Listen to my commands and keep your punches up. You've been justified in taking a point away there, Barry?
I don't think so. There was the first offence. I don't think it was a heavy shot, but the warning sign's there now, and any more infringements, I'm pretty sure he will get a point taken away. So it just adds a little bit more pressure.
Well, maybe just make Tyson now get down to business. Third round. And Abel down to that low blow. Oh, that's a terrific right hand. Great right hand from Tyson Fury. Well, that was hand speed, accuracy, timing. Does Abel want any more of that? Tyson Fury pretty much thinks it's all over. I think he's lost his gun shield, so happy to have a chat. He's picked it up and managed to put it in again himself.
It was a great shot.
Great right hand. Yeah. Never done with this
little
far,
more
is
work
it?
To do.
Well, I don't know what happened there, but the referee just put them back to their both to their corners, but give Abel valuable seconds to recover.
And I think that shot was made possible by the jab. Sticking behind the jab as long as he did, making it very difficult for him to look and find an opening. And all of a sudden, boom, the right hand comes down the pipe.
Happens. It was a quality right hand, and Fury's giving Abel plenty of verbals, inviting him on, suggesting he could take a bit more. Right hand again from Fury. He's looking for it. He's looking for what could be a knockout blow if he can land it again on the button. Seconds counting down at the end of this third round. Oh, a good left hand and a good right hand too, landing simultaneously. Abel goes down. Fury is ordered to the neutral corner by the referee. The American is up on his feet, he's recovered, but twice down in that third round. Smiles all round for Tyson Fury, and that's going to be 10-7.
Yeah, big, big round for Tyson Fury, and Joey Abel was doing a decent until the first knockdown. He just done a double jab, and he just stepped behind the first jab, didn't he, Eddie? And then shortened that right hand, and then pushed it, extended it all the way through.
The jab made it available. You know what I mean? He was looking for the jab all night. See what he did? Lean right into the right hand. Perfect shot.
And then the second time, the second knockdown. There we go. Two of them landing virtually simultaneously, and then the little right hand putting him down.
All Fury supporters, including myself, gotta love the result. But very, very dangerous shot that Tyson threw. You know what I mean? And you gotta be very, very careful with that.
That second knockdown was more like the Tyson Fury knockdown, where he takes too many risks.
Yeah, exactly.
But the first knockdown was technically very, very good.
Exactly. Couldn't agree more.
Into the fourth round. That would go down on the cards. Two knockdowns. They go down as a 10-7 round for Fury. Scheduled for 10, this one. And Fury looks as though he's on the verge of victory. Referee wanting to see a sense of decency preserved.
Yes. We don't want to turn this into, I don't even want to say it.
Let's not go there. We know where you're coming from.
Right.
But more importantly, those two knockdowns puts Abel back in his shell.
Exactly.
It makes him more tentative to want to commit himself.
Oh, he's looking. Oh, good right hand from Abel. Catches Fury that time. And just when he looks as though he's looking to tee off a big right hand himself, Fury. And now he turns the tables and comes back. Down he goes again for the third time. Well, there you go. He says, I like more than anything a ruck. He was caught by a big shot. And he turned the tables, turned round, put the attack on his man. And down he went for the third time. There's bruising under the right eye of Fury. He was caught by a terrific right hand from Abel.
Nice corner shot.
And now in the fourth round, maybe Tyson Fury is closing in. Another big left hand from the American.
Well, Tyson just changed southpaw, didn't he? Got caught. Oh, lovely.
It's all over this time. He's shaking his head a little bit disconsolately. That's the fourth time he's been down, second time in this round. Are you okay? Are you sure? But Jeff Hines says no, enough is enough. And I think that's a merciful conclusion. The crowd wanted to see a genuine knockout. That's why you're getting a few boos. But I think the referee's made the right decision.
I agree. You know, you don't want to get too many beatings, like too many punches like that to the head. He was defenseless in certain ways. You don't want to take too much punishment like he was taking.
I agree with you. He could have gone on, but he was only going to get hurt. Yeah, you've seen him when exactly. He's on his knees, shaking his head, sort of looking at his corner to say, no, I don't know what to do now. I mean, I'm under pressure here, and he's a brave guy, and he would have carried on, but you're right, Ed, he just would have got hurt. Yeah.
Wild, wild, wild entertainment as ever, though, in a Tyson Fury fight, wasn't it? It was real seat of your pants stuff. I mean, it was a bar of brawl at times.
It was a typical Tyson Fury fight, wasn't it, where he's showing some technical ability, then he's showing some flaws where his head rules his heart, rules his head, he doesn't get involved in a war.
Absolutely. I tell you what, that's a good right hand he's been caught with there. That hurt him. But look at the way he just turns around and just puts it right on his man.
But to be honest, I don't know where we're surprised, because he tells us he's going to do this. Yeah. He don't say, I'm going to box technically superb and dance on the outside and do everything right. He says, I'm going to get a tear up, I'm going to get knocked out, but he's going to get knocked out.
And it was actually true. You know what I mean? It's a good time watching.
Sweet science it ain't, but you can't take your eyes off it, can you? It's good to watch, and he's done what's necessary. That's the final analysis. He's picked up the win, and so the victory roll continues. It's now 22 out of 22, Barry.
Well, it's good, and do you know what? The first knockdown was perfect. He threw a jab, he threw a double jab, but he stepped in with the second jab, and then turned from the waist, turned from the core with that back right hand, and pushed the punch right through the target. And Abel had nowhere to hit the floor. The first knockdown was perfect. The next knockdowns were typical Fury, where he likes to get involved, he takes too many risks. But that's what we love about him. That's why everyone tunes in, everyone comes here to watch him, because they know you're going to get excitement, and it's always on a spin of a coin with him.
I don't know who's been messing about with his property back home, but he's a brave man on the basis of what we've just seen, or a brave woman, who knows. Tyson Fury, though, formidable and fun. Winning with a smile on his face. I'm sure we're going to get a most engaging interview in the minutes ahead. But now, as the fighters come together, Joey Abell has recovered. And I think in a moment we can get confirmation of that fourth round stoppage victory and another win for Tyson Fury. And here is Mark Burness.
Ladies and gentlemen, at 1 minute 36 seconds of the fourth round, your referee has stopped the contest. He deemed Joey Abell in no position to continue. The winner in the blue corner from Palm Beach Gang, Tyson Too Fast Fury!
The crowd really enjoyed that. They'd have liked to have seen yet more of it. I'll tell you what, I rather enjoyed it as well,
Joey Abell.
Derek Chisora is still to come. Thank you very much indeed, John. We'll have a word with Tyson Fury in a moment. A typical Tyson Fury cameo there, going into the ring, singing. A lot of wisecracking, a little word with our studio guest Eddie Chambers during the fight, taking a couple of shots. Bit of controversy as well, a low blow in